You know, it's a beautiful day today. You know, what a beautiful day, and this is the 10th day of the state fair. And the 10th day of state fair, we created the Hmong American Day. How about that? So I have here a resolution that I brought from the Senate, and a few of my helper volunteer will help me read this resolution. So resolution said, recognize September 5th, 2016 as Hmong Minnesota Day at the state at Minnesota State Fair.
Whereas Minnesota State Fair has operated for 157 years as a festive gathering where Minnesotans showcase competition, agriculture, food, merchandise, rides, and industry, and
whereas 2016 marks the 41st anniversary since the first Hmong came to Minnesota as refugees from Southeast Asia, and whereas
Minnesota is now home to an estimate of 75,000 Hmong Americans who have assimilated in all walks of life, and
whereas the Minnesota State Fair organization has partnered with the Hmong Minnesota community to celebrate the rich culture, stories, and heritage of Hmong Americans, and
and whereas Minnesota State Fair has designated Monday, September 5th as Hmong Minnesota Day at Minnesota State Fair, and now therefore be resolved by the Senate of the State of Minnesota that it be recognized September 5th as Hmong Minnesota Day at the Minnesota State Fair. And I will present this to Thao Tou Xiong. Wow. And thank you very, very much for your leadership. And Liz and everybody else for helping and make this day possible. And again, on the 10th day of State Fair, God and we created Hmong Minnesota Day at the Minnesota State Fair here. And so I'll be here all day, just to let you know. I'll be here all day from 12 on to 2. I'll be at the Senate booth. So all of you, welcome to come there. Talk to me about issue. Talk to me about what you want. And also, I'll be back there after I get off the stage to register voters. So all of you who are just about to turn 18, by November 8th, I ask that you come and register. My district 67 and Frogtown 65 are the two lowest turnout districts ever. So I wanna boost up the voters. So you have to register and vote. Be part of this society. You are part of this society already. You born here, you are Hmong, but you're born here. So you are part of this society already. So register to vote. So thank you very much. I'll pass this mic to my best friend and Councilman Dai Thao.
Thank you, Senator Herr. Good morning. Good morning. Woo! All right. I want to thank Lang and the organizer. I want to thank the sponsor. Without the sponsor, we wouldn't be able to be here. I want to thank all the artists. I want to thank all of you for being here. And I also want to thank our veterans who serve in the military for joining us here today. My name is Councilmember Dai Thao. I represent Ward 1 on the St. Paul City Council. It's a real honor for me to join you today to celebrate Hmong American Day at the Minnesota State Fair. I remember when I was a little kid, maybe 10 or 11 years old, my mom and dad would take our family here to the fair. And even though we didn't know a lot of English, we can see that, you know, where the good foods are, we try those, and it was making real memory. And so today it's a pleasure for me to also bring my family here, back here, right, to make new memory with you all. You know, it's among Hmong Minnesotans are hardworking, and all year long we work, we farm, we organize for change, and so it's important that on Labor Day we come to celebrate and support the Minnesota State Fair. Now, even though there's only 80,000 of us in Minnesota, we generate over 400 million in taxes, and we have one of, oh yeah, we can clap, oh yeah. And we have one of the highest percentage of home ownership. But we can't get complacent. 25% of our families and elders are still living in poverty. Our graduation rate is still low, and our youth unemployment is still high. So there's work to do to improve the quality of life in Minnesota, which is why in St. Paul, I spearheaded the Earn Sick and Safe Time Ordinance. There's 73,000 workers in St. Paul. Whether you're part-time or full-time, you'll have access to Earn Sick and Safe Time. With that, I want to thank Mai Chong over there. She's my LA. She worked really hard on this legislation. And then I also want to recognize Chris Young, who was my he was my intern, and he was tasked to study the Seattle ordinance, which is one of the ordinance that we model after. We're also working to ensure that every vendor that works with the city of St. Paul, if they want a contract with the city of St. Paul, they also have to hire youth from the city of St. Paul. And then you heard just recently that we've got the Minnesota United soccer team, franchise team. They're going to build a soccer stadium at the Midway site where Rainbow Foo is, where Midway Bowl is. We're going to bring lots of jobs into that area, and I'm proud to be a part of that. Families and friends, we live in a challenging time in the world, and there are people like Donald Trump who seek to divide us. But I say we must stand united. Instead of fighting each other, we have to fight for each other's American dream. And to do that, we need diversity in government. And that is why we have to elect Hillary Clinton as our first woman president of the United States. He told me not to rush.
Yeah. Take your time. Dad, we got all day.
All right. It's only 90 degrees.
We also need to elect Fru Lee to the House of Representatives. We also have to elect Susan Pa to the Brooklyn Park City Council. And we have to re-elect Senator Foung Hawj to the State Senate. In the United States and in Minnesota, our diversity is our strength. Our diversity in our thinking, our diversity in our history, that's what makes America great. That's why America is already great.
All right, thank you, Dai.
Thank you.
Up next, we have
our newest,
the youngest, and a city council member in Maplewood, yeah. Thao Tou Xiong, everyone. City
hello, council hello, good morning. Good morning. Good morning. 我找到谁的都共被new day today here at the State Fair. I want to thank you guys so much. Thank you everyone to all the sponsors, all the organizers, all the staff team, all the campaign teams. Campaign before we know how hard it is. They know how hard it is right now. And we want to encourage you all to go out and vote. Thank you all so much. We want to continue this great effort, and we want to help support our community together and, you know, bring everyone together. And we want to thank all these young folks so much. And we're very proud. And thank you all so much. And have a good day at the State Fair. We'll be here all day. All right. Thank you.
What's on up? All right. Up next, we have candidate Foo Lee running for state representative.
Hello, everyone. Can I just ask, is anybody here from North Minneapolis? Woo! So I just want to say thank you all for being here today and for inviting us out to be here. And for me, you may heard or may not heard, I won my primary election on Tuesday, August 9th. So I'll be the Democratic nominee for the state representative seat in District 59A, which is the northern half of North Minneapolis. And going forward, we still have a lot of more work to do to really turn out the vote in our district too. Like Senator Foung Hawj said too, at North Minneapolis, we also have one of the lowest voter turnouts. So I really encourage you all to get out there and make your voices heard. And you know, today as we celebrate Hmong Minnesota Day, we should also remember that there are still injustices happening outside in our community. So we really need to be more active and more engaged. And after today, feel free to get out there, talk to your families, friends, and really get them to come out and vote this year, where we have the presidential elections, we have the State House and State Senate, like Senator Foung Hawj and I. And then most importantly, we also have the local seats, like Susan Kayeng Pa running for a city council member in Brooklyn Park. So really encourage you all to get out there and make your voices heard on Tuesday, November 8th. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Finally, we have saved the best for last, right? Susan Pa, she just released a book last year called Success That Looks Like Me.
What a prophecy.
Yes, success that looks like you. So yes, let's help make her successful this fall at the ballot box in Brooklyn Park.
Can I just also point out, Susan is the only woman who is pursuing the next political, yes. Please give it up for the sister.
and our wonderful hosts and MC today, two jurors in that book. Isn't he awesome? Woo! Hi, everyone. My name is Susan Pa, and I'm running for city council in Brooklyn Park. My husband, Nick, and my amazing team is here today with me. We are all thrilled to be here with all of you at the Minnesota State Fair. Every year, I look forward to coming here with my family. We walk around and we look at all the different exhibits and the animals. And you know, the greatest thing is all the great food, right? The greasy food here that we enjoy. That's my favorite. Martha's sweet chocolate chip cookies. That's usually my kids' favorite. But of all the fun things to do here, my favorite thing has always been the rides and the games. No matter how old you get, you still love those rides. Because at the heart of it all, we're still a kid, right? Today, I'm especially excited to be here and celebrate with you the many different cultures that exist here in Minnesota, one of them being our Hmong culture. It is great to be here at the Hmong Minnesota Day, here at the State Fair. This is a great example of diversity and inclusion. As we celebrate our unique differences, we also share our similarities. We seek to learn about other people's perspective as we broaden our own. Today, as you enjoy the festivities, remember that you're part of something really great. This is the greatest Minnesota get-together, and it's all about community. I am so proud to be a Hmong American, and that is why I am running for city council. Because I want to build a future where everyone matters and where all of us have all the opportunities to prosper and live to our full potential. Thank you so much for your time. Have a great day here.
Well, there you have it. Susan. Get out and vote, everybody.
There you have it. I just want to take a quick second to appreciate the representation, the Hmong representation, the Hmong voices in politics at the state level with Senator Foung and soon Foo. That's two Hmong voices that have, you know, historically not been there. And then at the city level, we've got Brooklyn Park, we've got St. Paul, we've got Maplewood. So this is real, truly inspiring, the whole slate of our Hmong political leadership here.
And by the way, the first Hmong public elected official was not in Minnesota. It was Lo Mong Lo in Omaha, Nebraska. He is a Republican Hmong. So just so you know, there are Hmong Republicans, there are Hmong libertarian parties, they're just like there are Hmong Jehovah's Witnesses and Hmong Muslims too. We are a very diverse group,
and
right?
And atheists and all of that,
and
right?
Then also a tribute to State Senator Moore, Neil Tao, all the public elected officials who paved the way for us. So thank you guys, and you guys may exit the stage with your team. Thank you.
Thank you,
veterans,
everyone.
Please stay here. Yep. Let's give them a big round of applause.